Now let's begin with the sets. Now I just want an answer from you. Can you tell me natural numbers less than equal to 10? Can you?
Yes, you can.
Can you tell me what are the vowels in the English alphabet?
You can. We can count on the fingers.
Okay. Now, can you tell me 10 famous mathematicians? You can?
No, no, you can't.
Why you can't? Because in the second example I asked you vowels in the English alphabet. You said yes, we can count on the fingers. We are knowing that A, E, I, O, U are the vowels. You can count it. But what about the famous mathematicians? In this universe, in this world, I can't say which are the 10 famous mathematicians. Okay, okay, forget about the 10 famous mathematicians. Just stepping in our school, can you tell me 5 your famous teachers? You are sitting here, 35 students. If I am just going to tell you, just pick a paper and just write down 5 famous teachers on the your paper, then will all the 5 answers written by you, famous 5 teachers written by you, by the 35 students will be same? No, because for the famous teachers, I have not defined it that how they are famous. Okay, so collection of vowels in the English alphabet, that is a set. Okay, collection of 10 natural numbers or collection of natural numbers less than 10 or less than is equal to 10, less than is equal to 15, that can be a set. Okay, that can be a set. If I am saying, just tell me how many boys or girls in your class are exactly of 6 feet, that is a set. Okay, so what I mean to say, what we can write a definition of a set? A set is a well-defined collection of objects. Okay, so I am going with the definition first. Now, a well-defined collection, a well-defined collection of distinct objects is called a set. This is what exact a very, very nice definition. Okay, now we have gone through few examples, we have discussed few examples, one more I am going to discuss, but before it, let me give you a small thing. The sets are usually denoted by the capital letters, by the capital letters of English alphabet. Is it clear? We are just denoting it by, we can write it by A, by B, like this, by X, by Y, by Z, but it should be a capital one. Is it clear? It should be a capital one. Now, last thing, what I want to ask from you now. Can you tell me 5 brilliant students in your class? Again, same question. Now, just tell me, is it a set or not a set? Oh my God. Half are saying set and half are saying it is not a set. So, let me clarify. Unless and until I have not well defined this word, brilliant, I have not well defined. So, for me, Every one of you is a brilliant. Every one of you is a master in his or her own field. In some students, they are good in studies. Some students, they are good in sports. Some students, they are good in dramas, in many fields. Okay? So then it means brilliancy, according to me, is not defined. But if I am saying brilliant students are the students who have scored above 90 in mathematics, now can you tell me five students, five brilliant students? Now you can. Is it clear? So this is a set. But earlier when I asked you five brilliant students in your class, that was not a set. Now, is it clear? Set is very much clear to you. So this was all about the set. Definition I have written, and I have just told you how we are going to denote a set by the English alphabets in a capital.